Hall of Fame inductee Royce Lon Alger, varsity letter winner in wrestling, 1985, 1986, 1987, 1988. Royce was born March 6, 1965, and grew up in Lisbon, Iowa, where he won three state wrestling titles and a national junior championship. Signing on with the Hawkeyes with Coach Dan Gable was natural, since the Hawkeyes were in the middle of nine consecutive NCAA championships. Royce made the starting lineup in his sophomore season at 158 pounds, and became a Big Ten champion and NCAA All-American. His junior season, he moved up one weight class to 167 pounds, and repeated as a Big Ten champion, and was named the Big Ten Wrestler of the Year and Outstanding Wrestler of the Championships. He topped it off by being crowned an NCAA champion and an All-American. His senior year was a repeat of his junior season, except he went up one more weight class to 177 pounds, and won another Big Ten championship, and was once again named Big Ten Wrestler of the Year and Outstanding Wrestler of the Championships, and finishing with another NCAA championship. During his three-year career, Royce was a two-time NCAA champion, three-time NCAA All-American and Big Ten champion, two-time Big Ten Wrestler of the Year, two-time Outstanding Wrestler of the NCAA Championships, and two-time Iowa Most Valuable Wrestler. Following graduation, Royce stayed on with the Hawkeyes as a graduate assistant coach while training for world and Olympic teams. He found as much success at the international level as he did at the national level, becoming a 1990 world champion silver medalist, two-time Pan American gold medalist, two-time World Cup gold medalist, three-time United States Open champion, and member of the United States national team from 1988 to 1997. Royce is currently employed by Transworld Systems in Des Moines and continues to assist in the training of young aspiring wrestlers. I present to you Royce Lon Alger.
Well, like my boy Frazier there, I won't be bringing anybody here that kicked my butt. We won't be talking about that either. It's nice to hear some of the old guys because they're really, you know, they're out of the, their terror's dead a little bit, you know, when they're still young and those losses still really bite, you know. You don't forgive those guys that beat you too easy. Hopefully I'll like that when I get a little older. You know, Gable set the bar so high, you know. We're not here to talk about him, man. We've been talking about him for 2 years straight now. But he set the bar pretty high. And you know what? This is a great honor. It really is. And I tell you what, I kind of felt it through my family more than I did for myself. Because, like I said, the bar was set so high. And you know, my goal was to be an Olympic gold medalist. And that's all you ever, you know, when you're in a prism of light, you don't see anything outside of it. But it gives me a little bit more perspective now that I have kids, and you know, I'm 47 now, but it's been a long road. I mean, honestly, wrestling was, you know, it's been a great joy, but there's been a lot of pain associated with it too. You know, when you take these losses so personal, and the reason I'm kind of innuendo with that is I got my family here too, and they've suffered a lot. Your family suffers right along with you with those losses, and when you're in the, you know, I coached over the Olympics this year, and it kind of brings back old memories and stuff. But man, I tell you what, I want to introduce. I've got an extended family here, but I'm not going to. I will ask three people to stand up. My mom first, Faye Carol Alger. She's chance to talk to her. I have a lot of people come up on the street and people that have met her indirectly, or even I've had people meet her at rummage sales. I am my kid here, but she has to stop going to rummage sales in our hometown. When you're wearing other kids' shirts to school, they don't know about it. It's a problem. But in my two boys, they're the ones that give me perspective. Elijah and Jesse can stand up together. They've been keeping me pretty grounded and kind of, you know, they've been a good thing for me medicinally wise after my competitive years and whatnot. But and I'm going to ask just the rest of my crew there, my brothers. Hold on one second, Randy, Ricky, Riley, Rad, and Roxanne. It's all ours. I know it's a long story. I'm not going to end it, but I'm going to ask them to stand up, and then after they stand up, I'm going to have their wives and their significant others, and my nephews and nieces, and everybody in my direct bloodline. Whether you can prove that or not. Just do that right now. So I can't even see. I've got this light in my eyes. It takes a village to raise somebody, and it really is. I'm a piece of a lot of different people that I met. There's a myriad of people that I can thank. I'm going to mention this while I'm thinking about it. I was mad when they mentioned Brooke Simpson saying he was a past letter winner. Man, we almost won the national title with that big oaf, you know? Brooke Simpson is a hell of a wrestler. He's a letter winner, but that's what I was a silver in the world. And it's hard when your highest accomplishment is your biggest nightmare, and I'm sure he can relate to that. Brooks, are you out there?
He's my left. Can you relate to that?
Yes, and I was a silver in the world. I can't go, hey man, I got silver in the world. I'm pissed off about that. And so is he. So I'm saying that for you over there, because everybody, I go to big functions, say, all right, let's have all the world champions stand up, and you're sitting back there. You feel that? Right there. If you ever go to one of his sermons, you got to come early, because you're awake a bunch of people, they get pissed. But I tell you what, I approach wrestling and life with the same ferocity as I do everything else. I'm pretty much unscripted with my life. It's been a lot of work, a lot of people that get to win titles and they're very cavalier about, oh, you know, this and that. You know, thank all these people. You know what? I read a quote where 70, if you're going to be really, really good at anything, 70% of that work is going to be done on your own, away from everything. I tell my boys that all the time. If they're going to foster some kind of belief in themselves, it's going to have to be themselves. It's not going to be a team. You're going to have to get up in the morning and dig in and get visible with your workouts. And, you know, in that respect, I'm pretty fair with myself. You know, there's things I could have and could not have done. I do not have any regrets, because everything's kind of made me who I am. I'm in awe that this event, you know, like I said, I actually got in trouble. I didn't tell anybody about this dinner. I was just going to take my two boys. They said, yeah, Mom's going to get a free meal out of it. Better bring her. And then I had one of my other brothers that said, I wanted to throw a party for myself down at the Nickelodeon. And I was like, you know, I'm going to throw this. Look, I'm going to tell Rand about the dinner. Well, the next thing I know, I've got six siblings call and wonder why they didn't get invited. So I'm like, you know what? I didn't ask you because I thought you might feel like you hadn't come. And, you know, that's part of being hard on myself a little bit, just because, you know, you got your goals here and there, and your game's got things so high up here. But you know what? In retrospect, I wouldn't change anything, not a loss. And Brooks now being a man, God-fearing man, he can explain too about the cross and sometimes your merits made me a better person. And I'm really happy to be a Hawkeye. Nobody wears those colors brighter and longer and louder than me. I always considered myself the unsigned majority anyway. But it's a hell of an honor, and it's a hell of an honor to stand with these other people. And you know what, I want to do it. It gives me perspective with my own children, because I know how hard it was. and I look, and I know how competitive it gets, you know, and I look at them and I want to fight those battles for them, but they're going to have to, you know, people have to get up and you got to paint your own picture. And I tell you what, it's been one hell of a ride, and I appreciate the hell out of this honor. And if you guys got any free time tomorrow, 7 o'clock at the Nickelodeon, I'm going to say that.